Breaking now, Steve Bannon steps down from Breitbart News as chairman. This is a developing story. Steve Bannon is stepping down as chairman of Breitbart News, after a tumultuous week in which his comments about President Trump and his family caused outrage in the Republican Party and conservative circles. The Hill reports. Stephen Bannon is stepping down from his role as chair of Breitbart News. Breitbart, the former White House chief strategist, confirmed the departure on Tuesday on their website. "I'm proud of what the Breitbart team has accomplished in so short a period of time in building out a world-class news platform," Bannon said. Bannon's departure comes after Bannon found himself at odds with President Trump over quotes Bannon made in the recently published Michael Wolff book Fire and Fury. In the book, Bannon called the 2016 meeting between Donald Trump Jr. and a group of Russians treasonous. The New York Times reported that Bannon was forced out by billionaire Breitbart investor Rebecca Mercer, who earlier this month cut ties with the former White House chief strategist. Bannon belatedly apologized for his remarks in the book on Sunday, but the White House rejected his apology. Bannon had recently apologized for his statements, but the president still took aim at him, labeling him Sloppy Steve. Here is Bannon's apology, that we reported on this weekend. "Donald Trump Jr. is both a patriot and a good man. He has been relentless in his advocacy for his father and the agenda that has helped turn our country around. My support is also unwavering for the president and his agenda, as I have shown daily in my national radio broadcasts, on the pages of Breitbart News and in speeches and appearances from Tokyo and Hong Kong to Arizona and Alabama. President Trump was the only candidate that could have taken on and defeated the Clinton apparatus. I am the only person to date to conduct a global effort to preach the message of Trump and Trumpism, and remain ready to stand in the breach for this president's efforts to make America great again. My comments about the meeting with Russian nationals came from my life experiences as a naval officer stationed aboard a destroyer whose main mission was to hunt Soviet submarines to my time at the Pentagon during the Reagan years when our focus was the defeat of the evil empire and to making films about Reagan's war against the Soviets and Hillary Clinton's involvement in selling uranium to them. My comments were aimed at Paul Manafort, a seasoned campaign professional with experience and knowledge of how the Russians operate. He should have known they are duplicitous, cunning and not our friends. To reiterate, those comments were not aimed at Don Jr. Everything I have to say about the ridiculous nature of the Russian collusion investigation I said on my 60 Minutes interview. There was no collusion and the investigation is a witch hunt. I regret that my delay in responding to the inaccurate reporting regarding Don Jr. has diverted attention from the president's historical accomplishments in the first year of his presidency.